We've discussed in recent weeks the fact that FEMA has been intercepting more and more shipments to hospitals of personal protective equipment, PPE. And Jared Kushner, with his little shadow coronavirus task force that still nobody quite knows what's happening, appears to be the person in charge of telling FEMA where to direct this equipment. And again, as we have seen over the past 2 weeks, this equipment is not necessarily going to places where it's actually needed. Great example, the state of Florida, run by Donald Trump's sycophant Ron DeSantis, has received millions of pieces of PPE to the point where we actually, at this moment, have a surplus. Meanwhile, other states, run by Democrats, are still suffering shortages. So according to a doctor writing for the New England Journal of Medicine, hospitals have actually had to resort to smuggling in PPE so that the federal government cannot steal it from them and reallocate it to wherever Jared Kushner wants it to go. Here's just a part of the story. This is absolutely fascinating. Again, this was published in the New England Journal of Medicine. Two semi-trailer trucks, cleverly marked as food service vehicles, met us at the warehouse. When fully loaded, the trucks would take two distinct routes back to Massachusetts to minimize the chances that their contents would be detained or redirected. Before we could send the funds by wire transfer, two Federal Bureau of Investigation agents arrived, showed their badges, and started questioning me. This was written by the doctor. No, this shipment was not headed for resale or the black market. The agents checked my credentials and I tried to convince them that the shipment of PPE was bound for hospitals. After receiving my assurances and hearing about our health system's urgent needs, the agents let the boxes of equipment be released and loaded into the trucks. But I was soon shocked to learn that the Department of Homeland Security was still considering redirecting our PPE. This is what's happening at hospitals across this country right now, folks. This is not a unique instance here. This is just a snapshot of what is actually happening in this country. These hospitals, rather than having to go the traditional route, they're making phone calls, according to this article, making phone calls to wealthy benefactors, asking them if they would be willing to purchase this equipment themselves on their own. Then that's when, you know, they have these unmarked or disguised trucks, meet them in alleys and load up with it. They're buying this equipment from other countries because they don't have it and they're terrified the government's going to steal it. Then they're at the whim of Jared Kushner. But here's the thing, folks. Donald Trump is out there telling us that we have so much PPE in this country, we're actually going to start giving some of it away to other countries. We're sending some of it to China right now. This is insane, and I'll tell you what's happening. My theory of what's happening, and I challenge anybody to prove me wrong on this, but we know for a fact FEMA has been intercepting these shipments of PPE. That's a thing that's happened. That is verifiable. Jared Kushner is the one in charge of helping FEMA determine where these shipments go. Donald Trump needs a win with China because he's still got to win that trade war because that's still happening. So what better way to grease the wheels than by taking equipment that other hospitals have paid for, getting Jared Kushner to redirect it as aid to China because they're also suffering these shortages? That is my theory about what's happening right now. We do know we are sending this PPE to China. We do know that FEMA has been intercepting it from hospitals. And we do know that Trump has said, we have so much, we have to give some of it away. And we do know that we're still experiencing shortages across the country. Those are all facts. That is indisputable. The only thing still up in the air is the motive. But I can tell you, based on what we've seen from this administration, I have no doubt in my mind that my little theory right there is what's actually happening.